Dear students, earlier we have discussed about general characteristic and classification of phylum Protozoa. Today we will discuss about diversity and importance of phylum Protozoa. As we know, the animals of phylum Protozoa are acellular microscopic organism found everywhere in water, soil, on the body of plant and animals. Although they are minute and apparently insignificant, but they are of considerable economic value of the mankind. The activities of these organisms can be divided on the following two categories. First is beneficial protozoan and second category is harmful protozoan. First, beneficial protozoan. The protozoans are useful in many ways and some of them are as follows. First is food. Protozoans provide food for insect larvae, crustaceans and worms, which are taken by large animals like fishes, lobsters, clams and crabs, which are eaten by man. Thus, they form sources of food supply to man both directly and indirectly. Second importance is symbiotic protozoan. Certain protozoans like trichonympha and colonympha etc. live in the gut of termite, which help in the digestion of cellulose. The digested cellulose is utilized by the host. Hence, both host and the vector or the protozoan, both are benefited. Third is insect control. Several protozoans control harmful insect by persisting their bodies. Fourth is helpful in sanitation. A large number of protozoans living in polluted water feed upon waste organic matter and thus purify it. Many protozoa feed upon bacteria and play important role in the sanitary betterment and keeping water safe for drinking. Fifth importance is industrial importance. The skeletal deposit of marine protozoan such as foraminifera and radulera from the oceanic ooze at the sea bottom. About 30% of oceanic bed is covered with the Globigerina ooze. These skeletal deposits are put to many uses. Some are employed as filtering agents, others are made into chalk and steel, others are useful for abrasives. Sixth importance is building material. The skeleton deposit in the sea bottom, or we can say the skeleton deposit in due course of time changes into the limestone rock. Limestone is provided by the Globigerina ooze, such as that of Cliff of Dover, which play an important role in the defense of England. Comerina, which formerly known as Nummulite, are the largest protozoan which form limestone. Thus, limestone bed are used as a building material. Seventh importance is oil exploration. Petroleum is organic origin. The skeleton deposit of foraminifera and radulera are often found in association with oil deposits. In this means, they help in the exact location of oil. Eighth, scientific study. Many protozoans are used in biological and medical researches. A holotrycha, Trichomena gallii, is used in nutritional research. The effect of various foods and poison have been investigated on the this protozoan. Now we will talk about harmful protozoans. The protozoans are harmful in following ways. Number one, first is pollution of water. Drinking water in natural condition is made unpalatable by the reproduction of some free living protozoans in it. For example, eosinophils bring fleshy odor like that of cod liver oil. Peridinium emits smell resembling that of the calm cell. Second harmful effect is destruction of animal of food value. Animals like dinoflagellates such as Noctiluca and Gonulex, when become abundant, are responsible for turning the ocean red. The water become foul and cause toxic reaction to molluscan like clam, oyster and mussel, and they become unfit for eating by human being. Third, destruction of wooden articles. Some flagellates like Trichonympha and Coelenympha live in the gut of termite and help in the process of cellulose digestion. In the absence of these flagellates, the termites will die or change their diet. Thus, such protozoans indirectly help in destruction of wooden article and books. Sixth harmful effect by the protozoans is reduction in fertility of soil. It has been observed that about 200 species of the protozoans are present in soil. These protozoans feed on nitrogen fixing bacteria, thus reduce the fertility of soil. Fifth effect is parasitic protozoa. The parasitism is an association of two organisms in which one organism lives at the expense of the other, giving nothing in return. The first animal is called parasite and other is called host. Parasitism is a specialized mode of life and various levels of it are found in protozoans. There are two types of parasites on the basis of their survival. Facultative parasites are those that can live for various length of time without the host. And second is the obligatory parasites are those which cannot survive when separated from their host. Depending upon the nature and degree of intimacy and the placement of parasites on their host, these can be divided in two categories, or these are two types of parasites. First is ectoparasites and second is endoparasites. Ectoparasites. When the parasites live on the external surface of the host, it is called ectoparasite. A few species like Hydra amoeba, Hydaxina, found in epidermis of Hydra. Costa nectrix, found in the epidermal cell of fishes. And Ichthyothrix, multifishes, inhibit in the skin of fishes. They feed on the liquefied host cells, causing various degree of cellular necrosis. These parasites are transferred directly from host to host. Second is endoparasites. When the parasites live inside the body of host, such parasites are called endoparasites. Now we will discuss about the endoparasites and their location. Following type of endoparasites are there depending upon their location. First is coelozoic. Second is histozoic. Third is cytozoic. First, coelozoic. When the parasites live in the alimentary canal or cavity of host body, for example, Entamoeba histolytica, Giardica lembia, Balanitidium coli, etc. Second, histozoic, which occupies, it means the protozoans which occupies space between the host cells, for example, young trophozoic of the monocystinium in the sperm morula of earthworm. Trypanosoma gabions live in the blood plasma of vertebrates. Third type is cytozoic. These protozoans live inside the host cell, for example, Plasmodium and Babesia in blood cell of host. Sarcocystis live in the stripped muscle of host. Now, the effect of parasitism on their parasites. Parasitic protozoans are usually simplified in their structure. They do not possess any elaborate organelles except the ciliate parasites. The endoparasites show maximum structural simplicity. They lack contractile vacuole, locomotory organelles, and ingestive organelles. However, coelozoic form like Trichomonas, Giardia, and Balanitidium possess locomotory and ingestive organelles. Surplus food is stored as glycogen, volutin granules, and chromatid bodies. Many parasites are aerobic as well as anaerobic depending on the availability of oxygen and their position. In some protozoans like Gregarina, develop the organelles of attachment. Occurrence of complicated life often involving cyst formation and rapid multiplication by Mirogoni and Cyzogoni. Now we will discuss about effects of hosts. The parasites are of two types, non-pathogenic and pathogenic. The non-pathogenic parasites are, or we can say, the non-pathogenic parasites have no noticeable ill effect on the host body. For example, Entamoeba coli, Trichomonas humanis, Endolimex nana, etc. The pathogenic parasites are those which cause ill effect of disease to the host. Transmission of parasites to other host and its infection. The infection of new host take place in two steps. First, they exist of parasites from the first host and second the transmission in the second host. There are many ways of transmission. Following ways are therein which the parasitic protozoans reach in new host. First is active migration. This occurs in epizoic parasites of aquatic hosts such as ichthyophthirines, which actively come out of the host, for example fish, and infects the other host. Second is direct transfer. This type of infection takes place on coming in contact of the other host, for example Trichomonas vaginalis. Third type of transmission is accidental infection. In this method, the new host is infected accidentally, swallowing of the parasites in the incestate condition along with the food and water. For example, Coccidia, Entamoeba, Histolytica, etc. Six is infection by intermediate host. This takes place in blood parasites like Plasmodium and Trypanosoma, in which a vector transmits the parasite through blood sucking, like Anopheles mosquito, Anopheles female mosquito. The developmental stage may or may not be found in the vector. Fifth way of transmission is congenital transfer. The germinative infective taking place at or before birth may occur in several ways, as placental transfer take place in case of Plasmodium in man, ovarian transfer has taken place in Nosema in silkworm, etc. Thank you.